Hey my friends, how you doing? It's time for another creative chat and today I want to talk about creating your own opportunities because I feel that is one of the most important topics to talk about and it's often overlooked and we get sidetracked and distracted by things like being gifted, having talent, 10,000 hours, being at the right time at the right place. Forget about all of those. Creating your own opportunities is much more important than that. And I want to tell you why. For example, I like to read biographies of very achieved people. For example, Tony Hawk, which is one of the most achieved skateboarders. And there is also Richard Branson, who started Virgin Air and Virgin Music and all these kind of things. Very successful, doing his own thing. Then, of course, there is Steve Jobs. You might like him, you might hate him. He still did whatever he wanted to do and was successful with that. And he risked it all again and again. And there are other books I want to list in my video description. For example, and this is one of my favorite books ever. It's called Tracks by Robert Davidson. She was a young woman and she moved from a safe life into the desert, into the outback of Australia to work for free for several years for guys who train camels to learn how to catch wild camels, which by the way are very dangerous animals. They can kill you in an instant, and train them to walk with her and carry her luggage. And she also learned how to build these wooden structures on top of the camels to strap her luggage to that. And then, and this is the most crazy part about all of that, she walked on foot without support, completely alone, through the outback for 2,600 miles from the center of Australia to the western border of Australia, which is absolutely incredible, and a lot of people would simply die even trying that. So that is very, very amazing. So why am I talking about this? If you think about a lot of these people, they started from nothing. They had no knowledge, no opportunity, no money. They only had a dream and they said, okay, I want to do that. And this, I think, is the one thing that really differentiates them from everybody else. It is to have a purpose in life for what you want to achieve, at least for that period until you achieve this. So this talk is not about success, because success is very relative. Not only relative based on what others think is success, but also based on what you self perceive as success. And the thing is with success, every time you reach a goal, you thought this would be the most amazing thing. As soon as you reach it, it becomes normal and you want to go the next step. So you always stay hungry. If I, for example, talk about my channel, I thought when I reached 5,000 subscribers, I would be super happy and I would be satisfied. But I was not. I was happy for a short time and then I thought I want more subscribers. And then I thought when I have 10,000 subscribers, I would be feeling like a certified YouTuber. And I was happy for a short time, but now I want more subscribers because I think, why can't I give my knowledge? Why can't I give my experience to more people around the world? Why is it so limited? What are all these kind of things that hold me back to give what I can give to other people? So success is very circumstantial. It's based on where you are right now and what you think is cool. But as soon as you reach it, there is another step to go. So don't talk about success, talk about opportunity because, and this is the most important part, the starting point of opportunity is that you don't care what others think and if it's cool or not. For example, let's talk about Tony Hawk's for a minute. This guy here. He's a huge guy and he makes huge tricks. He's amazing. But when he started out, he was too small, he was too weak, he was too young, and skateboarding wasn't cool at all. But he stuck with it because he really wanted to do that. One thing I think is very important about creating your own opportunities is to be annoying and not taking no for an answer and saying, I want this and I don't care what you do and I don't care if you feel like this is the right choice for me. I still want to do this. And a lot of that, as I said, is based on a feeling of purpose in life. And you might say, yeah, well, I don't have purpose in life. I don't know where I go. I don't know who I am. And believe me when I say I'm probably the person with the least feeling of purpose in life ever. I'm always searching for who am I? What can I do? You don't have to immediately have this kind of purpose in life thing, but what you want to have is kind of a conviction at the moment. And this is I think the magic door open, and I experienced that several times in my life, that if you feel like you really want to do something and you're really convinced that this is the right move for you and you ask others for help and they see that you have this purpose and conviction inside of you, you radiate out this kind of energy, a lot of people will start to help you. And the reason for that is because we appreciate that. Everybody's searching for a purpose in life. And if you meet someone and he radiates that feeling, you still feel like, wow, this is some story I want to be part of. And in as little or as big as a way I can, I want to support that person and help that person reach that dream. So having conviction, having a dream, automatically also opens you opportunities to do things. And even if the opportunities don't open for you, even if all odds are against you, if you feel that this is the right thing and that if you feel that this makes you happy, you should still do it. As long as you can pay your bills, as long as you can live your life while doing your thing, that is all you need to have. This is all you need to do things. And by the way, and this is the last thing I want to say in this video, it always feels like starting something new is a real big risk and hardship and painful and stressful and all these kind of things. But for example, with Robin Davidson, she didn't go out there day one and cross the desert. She trained and trained for years to understand every element of the journey. And then she started. The very first step is always learning the basics, and that is always very easy. So for her, the starting point was picking up camel shit. Yes, that's the starting point of becoming a great adventurer and one of the most amazing women on this planet. So don't be worried about the start, because the start will always be simple. You will say, thank you everyone for giving me the opportunity to pick up this camel poop, because this is the start of my journey. Think about it in a positive way and create your own opportunities. Thank you and have a good day. Bye.